Being a Bassmaster Elite Series Pro is not all sunshine and rainbows. Every tournament brings a new set of challenges. Your next paycheck is never guaranteed. Day in and day out, the world's most talented and intimidating anglers stand in your way. You have to find a way to be great every single day. Providing for your family means survival in this sport. Finding your way into the cut on every lake in America. Your bags, girl, let's get out of Dodge. Sick of living life, sick of count scars. We the ones who go to war against the guys. We the this is that move around life the dogs. On the cut line.
All right, here we are, day one of practice for the 2023 elite season down here at Lake Okeechobee. Forecast for today, it is going to blow. It's going to blow west-southwest. We got a little bit of a front coming through. And it's better than it was when we left out yesterday headed down here. It said 25, gust to 52. I think it's going to be somewhere around 15, gust to about 40, which still pretty tough on a place this big. It's going to fish small because the grass is not there like it used to be. And it's going to be all about finding that fishable water and what is going to still be fishable come Derby Day. So we've got 3 days of practice, an off day, and then the tournament starts. So we're going to have some time for the weather to stabilize, for the lake to get back cleared up, hopefully. And after this little front moves through, we're going to have a couple cold nights. It's going to make practice kind of a challenge. I think any place that you get a few bites in, you can't ride off. So we're going to get after it today and see if we can find us a couple good areas.
one of the most brutal days I've ever had on this lake, just as far as conditions and not getting bites. One takeaway, when I did slow down, even though, you know, it wasn't conducive to throw it, when I slowed down and flipped a trick stick around and really kind of picked stuff apart, I was able to get some bites. And whenever that's the case here, it usually means the fish are spawning, you just can't see them. When they get in that mode, they don't want to chase moving bait. And that's what I kept in my hand most of the day. But tomorrow, we're not going to have as much wind. I'm going to slow down in some of the areas that look productive today that I couldn't fish. And just see if we can get some bites and get something figured out. It's one of those, this is going to be one of those tournaments that's going to materialize, you know, probably on our off day. Those fish are going to get, you know, some sunshine and some warm temperatures after this run. And whoever's going to catch them isn't going to know it's going to go down until the tournament day. So hopefully we're that guy. Even on the tough days, you got to take something away. I just feel like if you just slow down and pitch around right now, and that's typical Florida, when you have a front come through, you got to slow down. You can't throw moving stuff, and they told us that today. So, but it'll be different come tournament time. It's going to be back in the 80s, lows in the 60s again. So, I don't know. We could have just stayed at the house today, I guess.
Two of practice, and as you can see, not exactly what you want here at Lake Okeechobee. It's in the 40s, the wind blew 40 yesterday, and now it's supposed to blow out of the northwest 10 to 20. So, I don't know. Yesterday was not very good. It's kind of blowed out everything, so we're going to kind of have to look at everything else again. That we looked at yesterday, but we're gonna look at some different stuff today, and then tomorrow go back over the stuff that we looked at. But really just finding that clean water is gonna be the deal, and if we can find it, I really don't have to have a bite in it or catch anything in it in practice, but you know, in the tournament, hopefully this cool snap really kicks them into high gear to pull up and spawn, and maybe we get a big wave in, we catch them really good. We're just not going to know where we're going to catch them or how we're going to catch them until the tournament time. But we still got a couple of days to figure it out, and we're going to get after it. Got a mangled up prop and a bent prop shaft. We're gonna see if it'll get us on plane. to get back to the truck to get to the service yard to get another one. But I don't think we're gonna be that lucky. So we'll see.
Yeah.
Mess my lower unit up if I
run it with the bent shaft. Yeah. I don't know either. I feel like it.
I feel like it can't be good for it.
No, I know it's not good for it, but I don't know if it'll like ruin it.
Yeah. Your prop shaft pretty good, like where your motor's shaking. Will your lower unit go out if you try to run?
You bend your prop shaft? No, it won't go on for a while. I mean, it'll take a lot of wear on it. How bad is the bend?
Pretty bad. It's gonna blow it back in.
No, it's gonna blow east tomorrow. And then pretty much east.
Did you get a nibble?
Not a freaking couple. I captured a bass.
Captured a bass. On old Junebug Tour swimworm.
Yes. I don't know if this was Junebug or Plum. I'll be dadgum. I done freaking caught me.
Drop a dot on that. How far are you from where you got those bites on a chatterbait yesterday?
A chatterbait?
Yeah, the ones that were just ticking it.
Oh, that was way down there. Below
Horse Island.
Yeah, it was Horse Island.
just wrapped up day two of practice, and it was a little more the same like it was yesterday. Very few bites. Wind didn't blow as bad, but still just trying to find somewhere that hopefully they're going to move into, or hopefully there's some fish there that you can get a bite. But we got one more day, so we're going to probably make a lap around this whole freaking lake, or at least one whole side of it tomorrow, just fishing the clean water and find somewhere to hunker in and just put our head down and grind, because it seems like it's going to be a big grind now, but we'll see what we can do.
Are starving me to death over here. What you looking at? What you looking at?
Smile.
You better not smile. Oh, serious.
I'm getting a feel for this.
All right, here we are in line for boat inspection, then on to pictures. They take a picture of our truck and our boat each year. We got to go through registration and all that. Headshots, so they use that, you know, through all the live coverage. Anytime they're talking about us, they'll have that headshot, and we'll do like a little motion deal, kind of animated for videography or whatnot. And then is our one preseason meeting that we have each year. After this, we don't have meetings. It's kind of cool. Used to in the past, we'd have to go to a meeting every event. Now they just text us our info after this one preseason meeting. Once we get that knocked out, pretty much got a easy chill day. We got all our tackle rigged, just got a few baits to tweak, and get a good meal and get some shut eye. We gotta go catch them tomorrow, find a way. Oh no, I'm up on my game.
He messaged me and asked me what kind of glasses I had that say tubs.
Be careful with them things two at a time, man.
Got one for my wife. She's feeding the baby. Don't be judging me. Southeast 8 to 18.
gonna blow.
Imagine it'll be 10 to 15 sustained.
Yeah. Man, that's gonna eat up a lot of time when we're down there. You know?
See, I'm gonna fish up here first.
I am too. And that place right here, it's a little bitty place, isn't it?
It's actually big enough to fish two or three bites, but I only got the bites in one little area, but yeah. I fished the rest of it and never had any bites. There was a local boat in there that fished in from the other way, but that's the reason why I thought it was so big.
Yeah.
And they hadn't got a bite.
Hmm.
And they were throwing a swim jig around just like I was. And I fished around on the upper end, like on the outside, because it kind of got a little clear. And I said, I'm going to run back through there. And I run back through there, and there's like nine of our guys in there. I'm like, what in the world?
Just wrapping up, getting everything rigged. You know, we're boating 94 tomorrow, so I guess it's a good thing we don't have anywhere to go, really. I believe we're probably going to end up driving a bunch of miles tomorrow. We're going to start up here on this end and kind of fish through a little rotation of some stuff that should have some fish and maybe it got better. And then, depending on that, we might be taking off all the way down to the south end of the lake. So we'll see. Hopefully it'll work out and we can catch us some bass.
Thank you, Mullins.
What'd you save yours as?
What?
What dots
do you use? They are hearts. Yeah, they're hearts.
Hey, format of SD cards. What's good
with that? What do you do?
Format
SD
cards.
What you doing
on USB for the internet working.
You serious? Mm-hmm. Didn't you have to get a new one last year too?
I'm turning into the parking lot right now. What ramp are you at?
I'm by the one that's got the four boats of the kind.
Okay. The one closest to, like, the big pavilion and all? Or big metal building?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I'm making
The other one's like a little single up there. There's someone's using it, too. But
yeah, I'm making my way.
It's going pretty fast here.
Not cold, but it's humid and damp.
Hey, hold up, man. I got something to say, man. Wait. What y'all out here for, man? What you here for, huh? Does your life matter? Does your life matter? You ready for this? You ready to take control? Control, are you taking control? Huh?
All right, this is day number one here at the first stop of the year. First day back at school at Lake Okeechobee.
Here we are, day one, Lake Okeechobee, the first event of 2023.
It was fairly warm last night, you know, 60 degrees. So hopefully it's better than it was in practice.
I'm excited and a little bit nervous at the same time. Practice was just a grind. It was tough. We had a lot of wind, cold weather, and these Florida fish just do not like these fronts.
Got a couple areas to go fish. Don't really know what to expect, but hopefully it got a lot better.
So really didn't get a lot figured out. Got a few bites in some areas.
You know, hopefully we can just go get some bites. It's been tough to get bit all week and just kind of build a bag, make it happen.
So we're going to go to those areas and hope that some big ones moved in. Hey, all we can do is go fishing and hope for five big ones.
See what happens. You know what happens when people don't take a shot.
They get deleted. Former Elite Series Rookie of the Year and Elite Series Champion from Florida. Get live for Drew Bennett. Get your feet. Let's go. Proud skater Yamaha Bros. Drew Cook. We the shadows that move around in the dark. Take your life back, take your time. Look it, welcome to the tribe. Check the rhyme. Look it, I was doing bad, couldn't find. Look it, now my phone ringing all the time. Look it, we the only ones, holy sons. Mama's dead, kids holding guns. Catch them early, put that poison in they bottles with a Donald Trump. Walking around with the zombies. I know my home team got me. Michael Jordan with the Scotty. Apollo 3 with the Rocky. We gon' take it fast, you can take it slow. We don't take no breaks, we just take control.
Drop out of school wave. Don't be a fool wave. Stop being a slave for minimum crew wage. Graduate and try your luck. Couple thousand for them books. What you got, a desk job or a sex job? Boy, you still getting with it now. Break the pillars down. I don't fall in love, I just hit it now. She said, why is that? I just gave a fast. Gave my heart up once and I ain't get it back. Turn into a savage, happy with the madness. Sick of living broke, trying to find a balance. Moving through the pain, but they steady fallon. Bearing all my fruits, feeding my battalion. Take it fast, you can take it slow. We don't take no breaks, we just take control.
Oh my gosh, look at that thing. Yes, she missed it three times. Can you believe that? Oh. Dude, they're freaking biting. My God. I am on a completely different lake.
sir. Son. Son.
Oh, yes.
Golly, freaking choked it too.
From Panama City, Florida, an Elite Series champion, and get loud for Drew Benton. My fish here today, Drew Benton, the pride of Panama City Beach, Florida. Is that true?
I don't know about that.
10 pounds, 8 ounces, puts him in 18th place. I heard there was a sign when you drive in, home of, no?
That is not correct. But it'd be nice if it was.
Super cool.
Yeah. No, today was just a tough day for me. I didn't get the big bite, and I fished. I was going to give myself 10 minutes to come back in, and I'm over there at, like, Grassy, which is, like, 5 or 6 miles away. And for whatever reason, I look down, and I'm like, well, it's 3:18. I look at my watch, and it says 3:26. I look at my Marshall. I'm like, what time you got? He says 3:26, so we just... I threw everything down. I had 4 minutes to get in. That Phoenix Mercury flew right in here, and I made it by 25 seconds. So that saved that from being penalized 3 more pounds by being 3 minutes late. So it could have been a lot worse.
I mean, you got the whole minute, so you're good. You're good. Any earlier would have been a waste of time, to be honest. Series champion from Georgia, get loud for Drew Cook. Five fish here today. Nothing else. Lee Livesey was very impressed with your limit here today. Five fish here today. 22 pounds, 12 ounces. He moves into fifth place currently as he tries to chase down his second Bassmaster Elite Series title and the second in just as many years. Get loud for Drew Cook. Show it what you want, I got what you need. I'm all the way up. 22 pounds and 12 ounces in fifth place. Gonna weigh this for Phoenix Boats Big Bass. Needs to go better than 8 pounds, 10 ounces. 7 pounds, 6 ounces, and man, that's the way to start the season.
Yeah, if you'd have told me I was going to catch that yesterday, I would have called you a liar. But, we bobbed and weaved around, and we landed on them. And it was really, really fun for like an hour. We just caught them, and then we checked out and tried to look at some other stuff and actually ended up losing two more really big fish that would have had a big bag. But I have no idea if I'm going to get a bite tomorrow. And that's the God's honest truth. I really don't know if I'm going to be able to go back where I caught them and catch any more, but I'm just glad we caught them on day one. You know, normally we dig ourselves a hole, and we didn't, and now we can only just keep going, and hopefully we can catch a really big bag tomorrow and move up on Bernie.
Love to see that happen. Keep it rolling. He's an Elite Series champion, a 5-time Classic qualifier.
Still more fish in there. Let's go get some guys.
And she was like, I was paralleling the mat, you know, like that bunch of stuff on the bank, and I hooked her, and she was trying to go in there, and I pulled her and was pulling. She jumped one time, it's like a 6-pounder. And then she come up and jumped again and slung my chatterbait back at me.
headed to the lake or headed to the canal?
I started at the point on the lake and was just fishing.
So you run out to the lake and fish back to where we caught?
No, I went to where I caught them that morning. That bay, the big bay. Not inside there, just fishing the main deal in the muddy water. And got bit.
Huh. What? Like just fishing the hard line?
Yeah.
So basically kind of where we talked that first day after you fished that pond. Like on that hard line? Just going back down towards Horse Island?
No, going like on the west side of whatever canal it is.
That's north and south. That bank runs north and south. That Indian Prairie Canal runs east and west and it comes out to the lake.
I created trails that they've never been here before.
This is the canal?
Yeah.
Okay. I started right here.
The south side of it.
On the main lake point and fished all the way to the canal.
But the inside of it.
Yeah.
Yeah, not
just
that.
Where it made the... Yeah. I started right there on the point and caught one like right off the bat. Like it's like 210. And I was like, God dang, you can get bit doing this. So I fished, you know, and I mean, it ain't like, you know, balls to the wall, but like every 15, 20 minutes.
Well, that's how he was catching.
Yeah, I pulled up this morning, fifth cast, caught one. I'm like, it's gonna be on. I finally got my limit like at noon. Ran around here and there, went back there to fish, eating cove, bay, fish back in there.
Remember.
And I broke it off on one.
You broke it off on
Dude,
one?
Dude, I broke two of them off today.
You broke two what?
Swim jig. Dude, I don't know. I had one, a great big one. There was reeds laid over.
You
should
have 30 pound today.
I should have.
Unbelievable.
There was reeds laid over this one little
clump.
And I reeled it through the clump and it come over one of the reeds that was laid on the ground. And whenever it hit back in the water, you just saw a mouth come up and just boiled. I just went, pow, broke it right off.
You reckon your guide?
No, it's 50 pound braid. Yeah. Set the hook too hard.
Yeah, well, that's exactly what it was. I mean, it was here to his motor.
You need some aid?
No, I shouldn't have seen it if I'd have just.
So I went to where I had all the bites on the swim jig. And I couldn't get on the bottom swim jig.
Really?
I had to flip a Senko.
Dude, so I started out flipping a Senko. I flipped a Senko. Me and that Cole Sands boy started in there. And it was 9:50 or almost 10 o'clock.
It was in South Bay when I was there.
What's yours run?
Huh?
What's yours running?
Well, just me, about 72, 73.
I thought it was gonna be fast whenever I first broke it in. By myself, I could get 75, and I was like, this is gonna be a fast one.
All right, here we are, day two. Sucked it up bad yesterday. I'm in like 87th, I think. Really never had a big bite. Never saw any big fish around me get caught. So I'm gonna make a pass through that area because it's Florida. We've had, you know, two warm nights. Big fish could have moved in there overnight. And we're just gonna make sure that didn't happen. And I'm not gonna spend any time in there trying to catch a limit. I'm just gonna cover a bunch of water. I'm gonna keep some moving baits in my hands. I'm gonna try to practice today. I've got a long day. I'm gonna try to practice and run into some big ones somewhere at some point. If you know, I can just run into five of the right ones, I've only got to have 20 pounds to get back inside that cut line. Or if I catch a really big bag, I can get back in the tournament. So we'll do our best to change the ball game.
Just got in the water here for day number two. Fixing to do some little last minute rigging and go out there and get after it. Hopefully we can kind of do it again.
You know, we gotta catch 20 pounds to stay up there and still be in contention. So that's the plan. I'm gonna go swim a jig around and throw a chatterbait, see if we can't catch us another big bag, maybe even a bigger bag. Hopefully there's some more fish moving up. There's more fish moving up, and there's no telling what could happen today. It could be really awesome. So we're gonna go get after it and see what will happen.
Take a loss. Competition's up, show 'em no remorse. Dominate. I'm trying to find a way, roll to the championship, we going all the way. My blood, sweat, your tears, let's make one thing clear. Y'all do not compete, this shit is my year. Dominate. I'm trying to find a way, roll to the championship, we going all the way. Swear I was born for this, so motivated, driven by the thought of it. My vision's towards the win, the finish line doesn't exist till I'm crossing it. The difference is sportsmanship, you live for the game, I die for the sport of it. Came up with the warriors, the strong might survive, but the brave are victorious. Sending my best of regards, 16 the champion squad, crisis at large. Everyone ate what we start, but the tables don't turn, that was ours. Got out my bag and got out my feelings, I'm killing. I took on the data, serving to block, feeling my tell of the vibe in the building. I'm feeling my confidence, go through the ceiling, I feel like the best. Don't be going up, I can't take a loss. Competition's up, so I'm no remorse. Dominate. I'm trying to find a way, running the championship, we going all the way. My blood, sweat, your tears, let's make one thing clear. Y'all do not compete, this shit is my year. Dominate. I'm trying to find a way, running the championship, we going all the way. L, so get with the deal, it's real in the field, so kill it, be kill. You others should chill, commit on my skill, I constantly fail, I'm trying to fail. Used to be dude that hated on the low, now haters brag that I'm the one they know. Now when they think success, I'm who they show. GPS, I direct them where to go, what's good to a go. Bottom line, I will lead the opposite to traumatize. Turn the home advantage to a homicide. I let them in trouble, talking out of line. I gotta tell them, get up on my level, defeating me, that's a never. I'm ripping it all apart to put it all back together. I'm raining no time forever to everyone's under weather. My only luxury time, that's something that my head up. Hold me going up, I can't take a loss. Competition's up, so I'm no remorse. Dominate. I'm trying to find a way, running the championship, we going all the way. My blood, sweat, your tears, let's make one thing clear. Y'all do not compete, this shit is my year. Dominate. I'm trying to find a way, running the championship, we going all the way. Dominate. I'm trying to find a way, running the championship, we going all the way. My blood, sweat, your tears, let's make one thing clear. Y'all do not compete, this shit is my year. Dominate. I'm trying to find a way, running the championship, we going all the way.
Now we're cooking with gas, son. Oh my God. Dude, did you see that thing come out from underneath there? God, I'm a bad man. Freaking troubling.
Chris,
give me some of that one.
Thank you.
series event of the season. Are you ready? Today, 22 pounds, 14 ounces, just like that. Back to back, parallel days, gives him 45 pounds, 10 ounces. Consistency and key in this game. Boom, shakalaka, giant bass. That is a fin freak of nature right there. Let's get a weight on that for Phoenix Bolt's big bass. Needs to be better than 6'7" for the day, 8'10" for the tournament. 8 pounds, 4 ounces, a brand new Phoenix Boats Big Bass of the day. And man, so tomorrow, I'm assuming the goal is higher than just getting five little ones.
I don't know what kind of work today, so I really don't know. Apparently, there's a big wave that pushed up today. It looks like a lot of guys caught them really good. So I'm hoping some more fish move into my area. If more fish move in and I can catch them, then it'll be good. But it's fun. Like, I had a blast this morning for like probably an hour catching them winding on braid, and had some really awesome bites, and you know, made a call late in the day, made a change actually, and then ended up catching 2 4-pounders and 8-4. So got a little something going for tomorrow. But my dad and aunt, my wife and the little boy, they're all here. My dad and aunt came down today, so I'm glad I didn't let them down, because they left this morning whenever we blasted off. I had no idea if I was going to catch them. So hopefully we can catch them tomorrow and make them stay here for a couple days.
Love to see it happen. Wish you luck. See you tomorrow. But unfortunately going to be outside the cut, the first stop of the Bassmaster Elite Series. Site 1, Bassmaster Elite at Lake Okeechobee. So, a tough one for you here in your home state, but go get redemption next week on a body of water that I think you got a lot of history on.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it. You know, Okeechobee is still real special to me. 10 years ago, I got my start here. You know, in 2013, I won an FLW event here, and that's what got this career going for me, and it'll always be special. It's just these last few years, I haven't figured it out. I don't know. It's changed a bunch since then. I wish it would get back to the good old days, and maybe one day it will, but I can't wait to get back, but I'm looking forward to the next one for sure. It's going to be nice to sleep in my own bed, and hopefully we'll have a better outcome than this one.
Looking forward to it, and I'm sure you will. He's a Bassmaster Open winner at Classic.
got done with weighing back of the house, rigging up some rods. Caught the exact same weight that I caught yesterday. Caught 22.14 again, but had one golly whopper, I mean, 8.5 or 8.25 or something like that, that really made my bag. So caught them all in the same area. We're going to live or die in there tomorrow, hopefully. You know, there's some more fish coming in, and we can keep catching them. But I think we're sitting in third or fourth place, so we're kind of where we need to be. We just got to keep catching them. We're going to go throw a swim jig and a chatterbait around again tomorrow, and hopefully we can catch them one more time.
Little pond. Fish raft. They come up schooling, and for 30 minutes, he caught him. Caught 30 pounds. So then,
30, almost.
No. Then he's just hanging out, and like, because he's got.
What'd Bernie have? Heard he had like 10 pounds.
Ben, hey, what'd I get?
Giving them boxers.
Thank you. Thank you.
You need drawers and pants.
Yep.
Here's a shirt.
Thank you. I'll go put these on.
Day three, made the cut. We're in fourth place. It's like 45 something. Had 22.14 past 2 days. Got pretty lucky both days. You know, caught two big ones the first day and one really big one yesterday. So we're gonna go back. We only got one area, so we're gonna go there and just kind of duke it out. And hopefully there's some more fish moving in. Hopefully we can catch them swimming a jig, throwing chatterbait, and catch us another big bag, get us a couple of those lucky bites and stay in that top 10 so we can fish again tomorrow, maybe move up and have a shot to win this thing. So that's the plan. We're gonna go put our head down and just grind. The weather has changed a lot from the past 2 days. It's overcast, the wind's blowing pretty good bit. So it should make things interesting. I think they should bite maybe. I'm not really sure, but we're gonna get after it and see what we can do. Might have to change it up, might have to throw a spinner bait or something like that, but we're gonna be ready for them.
Georgia, get loud for Drew Cook. To fifth place currently with 57 pounds and an ounce, and a good tournament because in day one, I mean, you really, you know, you day two, you told me, man, I didn't expect what happened on day one. You continued it all the way through to the third day here.
Yeah, I had no idea if I was going to get a bite, you know, day one, day two, or today. And I milked my little area for all she was worth. The wind blew all the water out, and I finally left with like 45 minutes left, and ended up culling a couple times. I don't think it's going to be enough. I think we're going to be right there, but I'm looking forward to getting home, you know, having a day off or having some time to get some tackle rigged for Lake Seminole. It's my home lake, getting to sleep in my bed. It's going to be awesome, but it is my wife's birthday, and I can't forget that. I tried to catch her a big bass on live, so I could say this was for her birthday, but that obviously didn't happen. But she has to deal with my little boy running around here. She's already got the truck packed up, so she doesn't have the stroller, so she's got to hold him and he's squirming. So we'll see what happens. I caught every fish this week on a swim jig, on a dirty jig, no jack swim jig, and a jackhammer chatterbait with a big bite swim on it. It was really awesome, really fun the first 2 days. Today, not so much, but I'm looking forward to coming back here. Hopefully they can, you know, work this out with the water level, with the core and all this, and we can keep this lake alive and not bring it to 17 foot and kill it.
Well, enjoy some birthday cake, and we'll see you on your home body of water. He's a two-time Progressive Bassmaster. Bassmaster Elite Series Rookie of the Year. He's a four-time Bassmaster Classic qualifier, a Bassmaster Elite Series champion, and next week he goes to his home body of water. He's a Bassmaster Century Club member. Get loud for Georgia's Drew Cook. In just a few short hours, these Elite Assassins will battle it out on one of the most fabled fisheries in all of the world, Lake Okeechobee, and you can watch it go down on FS1 starting at 8 a.m. One more time, let's hear it for your top 10!
Alright, day 4, Championship Sunday. We made it. It's still, we didn't have the best day yesterday, didn't have a very good day at all, honestly. I think we kind of milked our one area for all she was worth, and water dropped out of it because of the wind. So we don't know. We're just going to go swing today, swing hard just in case it's a strike. And, you know, just go look at some new areas. Yesterday I left with about 30 minutes left to go. I culled three times in one area, so I'm going to go back to that area and fish around and see if we can't, you know, figure something out, make something happen today. We're gonna have to have a really big bag to win, but the more points we get now, the better. You know, the more later on down the season, whenever we need those one or two points, we'll have them if we can gain some today. So that's the plan, move up as high as we can go, make more money. But at the same time, we can't really fall. So we did our job this week. Hopefully we can go out there and catch a big bag today and see what happens, make things interesting. Them boys are gonna catch them, they've caught them every day, so it's up to us. We'll be right back.
rolling. He's a former Elite Series Rookie of the Year. He is a four-time Bassmaster Classic qualifier. He's a Bassmaster Century Club member. He is an Elite Series champion from Georgia, Drew Cook. Nicky, 7 pounds and an ounce. I've never been happier to see a boat pull up to the stage in my life. 57-1 start today. He's got 5 fish looking for 13-2. 9 pounds, 10 ounces. He moves into sixth place with 66 pounds, 11 ounces. And what happened? Just too much pressure on the fish? Did they succumb to that finally?
I mean, I was buying time from the get-go, honestly. Just the little area that I had, I was worried what happened was going to happen, so I just rode it until it was done. And you know, yesterday it was done. But I caught all my fish this week, the first 2 days, well, really every fish, on a chatterbait with a big bite kamikaze swim on and a quarantine crawl as a trailer, and a dirty jig swim jig, a 3/8 ounce with a big bite trailer on it. And that's just so much fun. Today, I went and looked at some stuff that I thought maybe if they're on, I could catch a really big bag. And with about 2 hours left, I just said, man, let's just go back to the river and go catch some. And we did. We came back into the river and skipped the swim jig. And me and my camera guy, we had a blast for the last hour and a half, catching a bunch of little ones. I lost one big one, but, you know, that's what it's all about. It's about having fun and, you know, just getting off on the right foot, making a top 10, first tournament of the year. Got good momentum. We're going back to my house. I cannot wait to sleep in my bed for the next week and, you know, fish a tournament at home. I'm really excited about it.
You're going to get there and you're going to have a lot of pressure on you. I mean, you're definitely going to be one of the odds-on favorites going into this thing. How are you feeling about lifting another trophy next week?
Oh, I would love to. And just to do it at home would be awesome. I think that the lake, the town, everybody's really going to show out next week like this. I mean, this is an amazing crowd. I appreciate all y'all coming out. This makes everybody doing this drive-through weigh-in without any of y'all would be terrible. But with y'all, it makes it, you know, so much better and so much more memorable. I know there's one rookie, Logan Latuso, that will never forget this today. And that's all because of y'all. But I had a great week this week. You know, I burned the batteries up, or burned the troll motor up, never ran out battle-borne batteries. I was looking for any type of bottom that I could see. And unfortunately, Lake Okeechobee does not have anywhere you can sight fish. But luckily, next week, we might be able to ice buy some.
Looking forward to seeing how it goes for you. Great start to the season. Let's.
You go to their truck, I'll get mine. I'll be over there for them. And Skittles. Always stopping for Skittles.
Sweethearts.
Sweethearts. No more stopping. I thought you
were already. Yep.
So this week I caught all my fish on a Dirty Jigs No Jack 3/8 ounce swim jig. I was using a swim bait trailer and the new Big Bite Sensation Ramtail trailer. I was also catching them on a chatterbait 3/8 ounce black and blue with a swim on, and I was actually catching them on a quarantine crawl on the trailer. After I would seine it, I'd go back, change my trailer, and go back through it to get some more bites. It's a really good trailer. And I just felt like with the scent, you know, if one was there, he was gonna bite it. But that's how I caught them all. Dobbins 734 Sierra Series on the chatterbait, and Ecstasy 745, and a Champion XP 734 Dobbins rod. I had 80 pound and 60 pound braid on my swim jigs and 20 pound fluorocarbon on my chatterbaits. You can find all this at Baitworks in the link below.